Hey guys, sorry I haven't had a video up in a couple of days. I actually got out of the hospital few hours ago. Got pneumonia pretty bad, so you're gonna have to bear with me for the next couple of days. I'm still working on putting the flea market video together. That should go up tomorrow. But I wanted to do one quick video in the meantime as kind of like a hold you over, tide you over kind of thing. So first thing I want to show you is no, not that, that's Forza. But I've kind of cleaned off my shelves and I'm keeping all the stuff that's going to the flea market in boxes now rather than having them on the shelves mixed in with all my stuff. Everything you see on these shelves is what I'm keeping. Sorry, I know it's a bit messy, but and then of course you got my weird stuff for my not for sales, my shields, and anyway. So yeah, let me just walk over here and set you down, and then I'll go over a few things that I've got that I hadn't showed you in the last video. How you guys doing? All right, pardon me. As you recall, I picked up a few Xbox 360s from a guy in West Virginia, the guy that owns the game store, and I didn't have any power bricks, I didn't have any controllers or anything like that, but I got all the systems at $5 a piece. Sunday before I went down, and after I did that last video, I tore them all apart and went through them all, and actually they all four worked. However, one has a bad optical drive, and anybody that knows anything about these stupid ass Xboxes know that once the optical drive goes bad, you either have to change the motherboard or JTAG hack them in order to put a new DVD drive in it, and it's just not worth it for something I paid $5 for. But I went and took a few pieces from one or the other that were interchangeable, face plates, things like that, and I made three good systems. And through some trading and some hunting, I did manage to find two power bricks, three sets of cables, and two controllers for $15. So, but here, I'll show you the first one. This one's actually the nicest one out of the three. It is HDMI or AV cable, and this one I used the nicest face plate. I changed all the springs for these so all the doors work, and it's got the white doors. I may actually keep this one and use it as my personal one. I'll just put a big hard drive in it. Or technically, all I need is the housing because I can use the 500 gig hard drive I have. I just have to put it into a old FAT style one. Just because I don't use them online, and even if I want to, I can just hook it up with the Ethernet. But yeah, it came out really clean and it works really good. So that one might be mine. I haven't decided yet. This is the second best system. Again, it is HDMI or AV. I wound up using a couple of tabs from something else. The door was broken, but I'm not really caring about that because it's not one that I was going to keep. I opened these all the way up and I disassembled all the drives so that I could clean the motors. So every single one of these, the drives open no problem. They don't stick anymore. Everything works on them. And then the last one, oh, really weird. This one, even though it's an HDMI equipped, is still running the very earliest version of the dashboard. It actually needs to be updated. It won't run anything new because it still has the old dashboard that looks like the original Xbox on it. Oh, shit. Hang on one second. And then the last one is an AV only. So it'll probably wind up being the cheapest of the three. However, it works fine. I had this one hooked up to my smaller television, and the picture's fine. It works good. Again, all you have to do is, well, it's not all you have to do because you got to disassemble the damn thing. But you take out the optical drive and you clean the band that's on the little motor that's at the front of the drawer. and that allows it to go in and out without sticking. For some reason, just a little bit of dirt on those bands in there can make them run like, or not open very well. So, but yeah, so there you go. I've got three complete systems. And if I decide to keep the fat for myself, I'll probably sell the slim, but then again, I might just keep both because between the two of them, I got 25 bucks into them. But I can take these out to the sale. I'm gonna go garage hunting. Hopefully, if my excuse me, if my health holds up, and try to find a couple of hard drives before the weekend. I know there's a few on Craigslist, so I'll have to check them out and see if they're out there. But yeah, I got these cables, which will go with the AV only system for $3. I'm just gonna give AV cable component cables with them because I don't feel like giving away my HDMI cables, especially when I have extra sets of these things. So two of them will have composite cables or component cables. One will just have standard AV cables. I do have to find one more power brick. Not a big deal. And then a couple of white controllers. We'll just, you know, one controller per system. Figure they're probably worth, you know, 40 bucks a piece. So we'll see. I'm sure at the flea market I can sell them pretty damn fast. Pardon me. I did pick up a PS2, but I traded it for some stuff to a thrift shop owner, shop owner that I know, and picked up some other stuff. One thing I picked up was a PS1. When I got it, it did not have a controller. However, it did have the AV cable. It's just the AV cable's hooked up to my TV right now, so I'm not gonna unplug it. Works fine. I got that, the one power brick and an AV cable for a PS2 that I had $15 in, so I think that was fair. And then I found at another shop this one, which is what came with this controller for $5. It's missing the little door over the parallel port, but it works as well. Now, it just had an RF plug, but I had extra Sony AV cords, so that's what we'll go with that. And again, they're both tested, they both work. I just got to find another controller, which shouldn't be hard. I'm sure I can find something out at the flea market on Saturday for Sunday. Pawn shop in Martinsburg had a Nintendo 64 with the expansion pack for, they had it marked at 35 bucks, but he sold it to me for 30 bucks because it has the Jaws Edition controller. I'm pretty sure that a baby shark was teething on it. The controller works fine, but the condition of it's just a little nasty. I'll clean that up though, but those expansion packs are still worth 20 bucks. This is a 3DS. It's the blue one. It just needs to be cleaned. However, it's got a broken charge port, but it came with a Nyko charge base, so it does work. That was 30 bucks. Probably get 50 for it out at the flea market. Let's see. Sorry if I'm a little all over the place. I'm a little loopy. PSP 1000. It was dead when I bought it. They said it's broken. I think the drive is bad. It tries to boot the game, but it doesn't succeed. I think the motor for sliding the laser is bad. Although, to be fair, that could potentially be my fault. Now, this came from the same place I got the other PSP, so $5, and the other one was $5. But this was on top of a 360, and when I picked up the 360, I launched this across the room, and it landed on the floor. So I may have actually broken that one, but the system itself works and the wireless works, so maybe I'll sell it as is or I'll wait for a parts one to come up. Got a copy of the X files for $5. Discs are flawless. Uh, I had this game when it first came out, and I sold it, but now I got it back. I got this one off of eBay for $9. I don't know if it's because of the movie came out or whatnot, but the price of these have gone up. They're selling for 25 used at GameStop now, so when I saw that, I figured I should pick that up. Plus, it's a fun play. It's a very short game. It's maybe 4 hours if you play it straight through. However, it's not a bad thing because the humor, while really fun, if it was much longer than 4 hours, would probably be too much. I traded a couple of games that I had, a couple of Wii games, and I got Fight Night Champion and Borderlands 2 and a copy of Ultimate Alliance. However, it's not reading. I think someone resurfaced it and didn't do it right, so I gotta go return that. Figured I just traded enough stuff for cash. I should probably spend a little bit of money in the local GameStop. And then the last thing, and this was probably, what was it, Sunday afternoon, at a store, I got Final Fantasy 13-2. They had 19 bucks originally. They must have had this thing forever because they sold it to me for $4. Valkyria Chronicles, again, for $4. And then he was showing me some stuff. He had like a Call of Duty Xbox, Call of Duty PS4 that he wanted. Well, he must not have known that they dropped the price of the new ones, but he wanted like $350 or $330 or something like that. But on my way out, he was pointing to some games and he said, here, all those games are $1 each. So for $1, I got Animal Crossing on the GameCube. But the best part is, it had the memory card that comes with it. And if you look, it said $4.37 just on the memory card. Now, game is in really solid shape, just a couple fingerprints, but no manual. But that's okay, I don't care. This is gonna go with my not for sale stuff. So, for $1, when am I ever gonna pick that up again? I think that's about it. I just wanted to do a video because I hadn't done a video in a few days, and I'm sure my 7 subscribers wondered where the hell I was. But yeah, so I was enjoying IV fluids for the last 24 hours. So yeah, I'm going to go to sleep now, and I will talk to you guys later. I'll try to get that flea market video up tomorrow. Until then, hopefully I won't die. There you go. Bye.